going back to where we were, we started the night out with the women's match cluster fuck cagey cage of doom backflip fun time. So in this, you had Damage Control. Let's see if I can get this right. You had Damage Control, and then you had Charlotte Flair. You had Becky Lynch. Who else am I forgetting here? My God.
Bianca.
I did. Bianca, and who was the last hit?
Shotzi.
I didn't even put any goddamn. And, oh, and Shitzi.
Shitzi. Yeah. Shitzi. Sir Shitzi a lot.
Yeah, yeah. So what did you think about this match, dude?
I thought it was very obvious, even from the onset, Shotzi did not belong in this match, Joe. That's what I thought.
No, no. Good heavens, no.
Right from the onset. Obviously, you have that Damage Control, Asian connection, Bailey with like the three heavy hitters from Japan vibe. Shotzi felt completely out of place. You know, whatever your feelings are for Becky or for Charlotte, you know, or for Bianca, these are the heavy hitters. You know, these are the top dog people. But I just felt like Shotzi, just like I, you know, felt, we'll get to the men's, where I felt like that half a midget guy was out of place. It just was, no, I'm sorry. He's a half man.
No,
he's
Tyrion Lannister. Wrong,
what do you want me to tell you? But as far as women go, Shotzi, I like Shotzi quite a bit, you know, but not in this environment. Didn't work for me. What do you think, Joe?
No. I mean, this was fine. You know, it just served its purpose.
Right.
This was one of those matches where, like I said this in the predictions, this could have gone horribly wrong.
Oh, yeah. You're right about that.
This could have gone
scary bad.
Real, real ugly.
Scary bad.
Yeah, yeah. And it was fine. I mean, you had more than enough people in here that knew what they were doing to pull off a fun match. It was still, if they decide to stick with this formula, the cage and, you know, whatever your War Games-esque thing, they got to cut it down to 3 minutes too.
Okay.
The 5 minutes between people coming and going, it feels a little long. And I know that they kind of fill that 5 minutes by the entrances anyways.
Yeah, of course.
Because usually by the time they put the clock up, it was at 3 minutes, but still it's like, you know,
well, there was a couple of big spots in the match, you know, that you knew were going to come from the Damage Control side. You know, but I don't think anybody, I mean, for me personally, Joe, I'll ask you, there was no part of me that thought, no matter what, how good they look during the match, Damage Control are eating this easily, you know, so it kind of took
absolutely.
Me out of it.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that was another one of those moments where you're going, all right, you made this a little too easy for the viewer. Mm-hmm. Okay. If anything, this card probably was a little too light on suspense, I guess you could say, outside of, hey, is fucking CM Punk gonna show up?
That was other than that for real.
That was kind of it. Yeah. I mean, other than that.
Well, they knew they had that in the bag. You know, they knew they had that to put on the table. So
yeah, they didn't have to. Well, that was it. They didn't have to go out there and shock and awe you, because they were like, okay, well, we know the last 15 seconds of the show, people are gonna, that's it, Dunsville. You know, easy peasy. But that was it. Like, the match, like I said, it was fine.
It was fine.
I see Bailey. Yeah, I see Bailey getting absolutely booted out of this group in the next maybe month or less. Do you know what I mean?
You think because of racism or just because of storyline?
I mean, maybe not even just the racist.
She's going to get replaced by a true Asian. Is that what you're trying to say, Joe?
Yeah.
Stop Asian hate.
Dude, you got to think of it in this way, too. The same way that you're looking and going, Shotzi doesn't fit in.
Yeah, here. She doesn't.
Bailey, too. Like, you're looking at it and you're going, it's not even a matter of them being like Puro girls or Joshi girls or whatever. Mm-hmm. You just look at Bailey and I'm like, all right, so these chicks kind of all have their own thing. And Bailey just looks like the thick bassist of a new metal band. Mm. That's all. Like, you're like, oh,
yeah.
All right. I guess she fits in there somehow. Like, no, I don't know. I don't see that.
Is that your favorite Bailey, Joe? Thick bassist Bailey?
She's the fucking bassist for like Cold Chamber. Yeah, no. That's what I'm saying.
I like get up off the floor, Bailey. Who do you like? Thick bassist Bailey.
But Joe, no part of, I mean, like, honestly, even with all that, you know, impressive Japanese profile, for the damage control team, no part of anybody thought, oh, they're gonna get a clean pin on Becky or Bianca or Charlotte.
No, nobody thought that was gonna happen. So that was it. I mean, it was a good opener, nothing too horrible, nothing too embarrassing.
Right.
And the team that everybody thought was going to win won.
Bingo, bango, bongo.
Couple little high spots. Also, thank you for Edward in the chat room there. He posted the picture of them in their masks. Not helping my new metal analogy.
Mm.
Not helping.
Slip crotch. What are we going to call this band? Slip crotch.
What was it?
Slip crotch. Charlie, its ass is so flat as a bug. Yeah.
It is looking like Slipknot does need a new drummer. So maybe.
Yeah, you might be. Get in there, bro. In there.
Yeah, somebody's going to have to move from.
Somebody's going to have to do it. I can't do it. You got to do it.
Oh my God. Yeah, so this was fine. This match was okay.
Did you know that Wrestling Soup has commercial-free episodes and extra shows all available at patreon.com/wrestlingsoup?
Follow Wrestling Soup on Twitter at Wrestling Soup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. No. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.